CIA was in effect acting as America's hidden Ministry of Culture.
While this document shows the CIA was working on the use of LSD and other drugs for unconventional warfare, evidence supports that the battlefield would include whoever opposed their racist pro-war agenda.
Flying in arms to our allies, flying back out with the heroin. The first target being U.S. GIs during the Vietnam War, the second target being the United States itself.
Infiltration of cocaine into the Black Panther Party, its leadership, Huey P. Newton being the main target.
The head of the DEA at the time, Robert Bonner, said that a ton of pure cocaine worth hundreds of millions of dollars had been smuggled into the United States. He blamed the CIA.
And we know the FBI had a 300-page file on Lennon. Much of it remains classified for national security reasons. The doorman at the Dakota that night was Jose Perdomo, a veteran of the CIA's botched Bay of Pigs invasion, a professional hitman.
I cannot think of a case in which I have had someone inject himself with a large amount of heroin and then proceed to kill himself. It just doesn't make sense.
We're speaking with Brother Tupac Shakur, who was the national chairman of the New African Panthers.
The Code of Thug Life is a revolutionary document. He began to broker the peace between these gangs.
In the ghetto off legal means, fight to survive, head pat.